All right, guys, we are back with another HAT format finals at Epic Cards and Games in Hurst, Texas. We got Creighton on the left playing HAT versus YCS Philadelphia champion Denis Nadas on the right playing Mythic Rulers. So looks like Denis is going first. Both these guys went X1 and Swiss. This is Creighton's second time in the finals. This Denis is, what, third time? But Denis has one win. So here he starts off by activating Dragon Shrine, which is a foolish burial for dragons, except you can send a normal dragon type monster alongside it. So first, I think you dump the normal monster first. Yeah, so he dumps Blue Eyes and Blaster with Dragon Shrine. All right, let's see what else he's got. Mythic Rulers have not won in the channel. I think this is the first time they even made the finals. Yeah, HAT's been in the finals already. Already has one win. Yeah, the Alex BDA won with HAT. What's the furthest Mythic Rulers have gone? I think top four is the furthest they've gone. I think maybe Lynch got top four with the deck once. Okay, dang, Denis is taking a long time. Let's see what he decides to do. I'm surprised how long he's taking. I take a long time too sometimes. A lot of us just started playing HAT, so it's understandable. It's not like we've been playing the format for years. So I hope everyone is patient in the comments, because yeah, we just decided to switch over from Edison to HAT because we've been playing Edison for a year. And yeah, it looks like he goes normal summon Crane. Normal summons Trapdict's Murmaleo, which searches a normal whole trap card. He attacks into a fire hand, and fire hand when it's destroying your possession and sent to the graveyard. Destroy monster your opponent controls, then you can special summon an ice hand from your deck. So he brings out ice hand. Creighton sets three and passes. All right. So this is interesting that Denis is playing the hands in his Mythic Ruler deck. So I'm guessing this is a Mythic hand deck. But fire and ice hand work well in his deck because he can banish them for blaster and title. And they just help deal with boards. Also gives you more rank 4 access. Alright. So Denis activates Redox's in-hand effect, which you can discard itself and another Earth monster from your hand. And it's basically a monster reborn. From your graveyard only, though. So Creighton chains Maxi to Redox's effect. So Maxi is a quick effect hand trap. You can discard it from your hand to the graveyard. For the rest of the turn, each time your opponent special summons, you draw one card. So Denis brought out Blue Eyes. So he's going to hit him for what? 44? Already half of Crane's life. Denis sets another monster. Probably another hand. That's what I'm guessing. Or maybe a Flame Veil Guard. There's not much else that Denis would set in this deck. Now Creighton sets another back row and another monster. Sorry, first monster and a back row. I guess Denis realized he's playing against HAT, so he's kind of like, I'm not going to really need Max C that much in this matchup. It's okay, but can he special summon Blaster? I mean, he can banish from his hand, but I'll go over the plays as they happen. Okay, come on. It is the finals, so also people tend to think out their plays a lot more. Let's see. Maxi, Blaster, Fire Hand. So he'd have to banish a dragon from his hand to bring out Blaster. I don't think he has anything else in there. So he's probably thinking, he probably set a hand. So, okay, so here he compulses the Blue Eyes. Ice Hand attacks into Ice Hand. I think it's 1600 defense, so Denis will take 200. So we're at 46 to 78. Oh no, he had Redox. He could have banished Redox too for the Blaster, but probably he doesn't want to waste it. Okay. I forgot he had Redox because he used the effect last turn. So it looks like Denis passes. Looks like Crane has his own ice hand in hand. Oh, I think he drew ice hand, double moral tag. Yeah, Crane's hand's not that great. So he normal summons ice hand, waits for a response in case maybe if Denis wants to activate Maxi, and he does. So he's going to get one draw for the XYZ monster that Crane special summons. Let's see what he decides to go for. He goes for Dweller, which is a quick effect. During either player's turn, he can detach one material and basically negate graveyard effects for the rest of the turn. That's basically what it does. So it's going to negate Ice Hand. And here, he can do it preemptively so that Denis can't special summon his Dragon Rulers, since in this scenario, they're going to be activating in the graveyard. So I think, yeah, he chose not to use Dweller's Effect there. So Denis special summon Redox by banishing an Earth Monster from his graveyard in one... I think he banished two Maxis, yes. Yeah, I had a feeling that that was a monster he set. It was either Flame Bow Guard or a hand. So here, Synchro summons for a level 8 Synchro. Let's see which one he goes for. Stardust goes for Stardust Dragon. Stardust is pretty good. And here comes Blackhorn. A really popular card in HAT format. It's hard to, like, you can't really play around that card. Except with Wiretap. So here, he special summons Blaster. Blaster gets bottomless. So you saw him, he special summoned Blaster by banishing Stardust and Fire Hand. So all the Dragon Rulers have three effects, but you can only use one effect per turn. So that's why he already... here he special summoned Redox, so he can't use the other effects. Also, the Dragon Rulers return to your hand during your opponent's end phase if they're face up on the field. So Denis activates Goldsark. Goldsark's Tempest, and then Tempest, when it's banished, search a Wind Dragon from your deck to your hand. He searches Debris Dragon. I don't think he's normal summoned. Special summon Tidal. So he reveals Tidal by banishing Blue Eyes and Ice Hand. Normal summons Debris Dragon. Targets the Flame Veil Guard. No response from Creighton. What's he gonna... Does he synchro for like a level 8? Get rid of the title, maybe a Spark Dragon, I think. Or does he go for Star Eater? I see what Denis decides to do. So yes, all the Dragon Rulers who you may not know, they all have the effect to special summon themselves. They have their in-hand effect, as you saw Denis use it with Redox, and they also have the effect when they're banished. So you saw Denis banish Tempest, that's why he was able to search, but like I said, you can only activate one effect per turn. So here, Denis decides to go for the Star Eater, take, and then, okay, the Dweller was at 22, so he took, what, 1,000, and oh, I guess he took 11? So we know two of Creighton's cards are moral attacks. I think this game is not looking good for Creighton. Depending on what that back row is, and he didn't flip it last turn, so if I'm Denis, I try to go for game. Before he draws into something, but he decides to just hit him for 32, leaves him at 300. Now Creighton sets two more, two of them being moral attacks. He attacks. Well, you can't activate anything when Star Eater attacks, right? Okay, he forgot to add the Tempest to his hand from Goldsark. Okay. Honestly, I don't think this Mythic Ruler deck is that easy to play. Like, me looking at it from the outside looking in, like, I don't know what the correct move is. I'd really have to think about it. Because you have to manage your resources with the Dragon Rulers. You can't just, you know, banish them, like, freely-nilly like you could in when they were at full power with three dragons, and especially when you had the three babies. Okay, so it looks like he's searching Mythic Dragon. So Creighton Divine Wrath the title, but he banished Redox, so Redox's effect is search, the Mythic Dragon activates. Normal summon is a Mythic Dragon, special summon is the Water Dragon. So you can special summon the Water Dragon if you control an Earth Monster, and then the Earth Dragon can copy a Water Monster you control, and it becomes the same level. So the XYZ summons a level 8 monster. I mean, this looks like game. I think he went for Felgrand, it's a Ghost Rare. I can't tell what Ghost Rare that is. This is why I don't like Ghost Rares on camera, because I can't tell from here what card it is. Is this not game? Maybe he's playing it safe. Does Felgrand come ghost? I think it does. So I'm guessing that's a Felgrand. Crane's got at least one moral attack down there. So he reveals Tempest. Synchros with the Tempest and the Flame Veil Guard. Or thought about it. So I played both of these guys in the tournament. Crane beat me. And Denis beat me. No, I beat Denis and Crane beat me. So he goes Sanctum. Special summons Beagle Attack. Now, will Denis negate the Beagle Attack's effect or will he let the Moral Attack go through? Let's see what he decides to do. So Artifact Sanctum Special Summon is an artifact from your deck. And the artifacts, if they're special summoned during your opponent's turn, they trigger. So here, he's going to trigger both. So Denis decides to negate the Moral Attack, but Crane's got Trap Tricks Trap Hole Nightmare. So I'm going to go over what happened here. So Trap Tricks Trap Hole Nightmare. If a monster that was special summoned this turn activates his effect, negate that effect and destroy it. So here he just attacks both monsters with Star Eater and Tempest. No, Tempest needs to go back to his hand. Oh, yeah. Okay, he remembered. Oh, he has Call. Oh, that's pretty good. But this is, I guess this is not game. The only way it's game is if Denis can summon two Dragon Rulers. Let's see if he can. Yeah, he can. Okay, this should be game. He has Call. Doesn't matter. Yep, Crane concedes. So Denis, one win away from getting a second win on the channel. So yeah, the artifacts, if they're special summoned during your opponent's turn, they're active, they trigger their effects trigger. So Moral Attack was special summoned during Denis's turn. That's why it pops a face-up card. Doesn't target. So Crane's going first. Summons Trap Tricks Mermaleo. Or Mermaleo adds Deep Dark Trap Hole, which is a bottomless. Except for level 5 or higher monsters. They don't have to be 1500 attack. And so sets 3. Then it starts off by setting a monster, setting one back row, probably a hand. And I know Denis plays Skill Drain, so I'm guessing he... Okay, so he summons Fire Hand, and here comes... Ooh, Malkat! I forget about that card. Yeah, so he gets rid of Divine Wrath, Sanctum, and... Can he... He could have chained Sanctum too, right? He could have chained Sanctum, I think, unless I'm wrong. Maybe I'm wrong. I think he could have chained Sanctum. But maybe if he chains it, he doesn't get to pop a card, so he'd rather just get rid of the hand. That's possible. So here, Denis crashes Fire Hand. Oh, he chains Maxi. Pops. Okay, so they're going to go over the chain link here. So I'm guessing Crane's hand will miss timing because the last thing to happen is the Fire Hand being special summoned. Okay. Sorry, the Ice Hand being special summoned. Brings out the Ice Hand in defense mode. I don't think anyone's taken any damage. One thing I've realized about Max C, I don't know if I like it because, like, a lot of times, a lot of the decks can just OTK you. Like, you need, like, Max C is good if you have, like, a board with it. Or if you have something you could draw into, like a Swift Scarecrow or Effect Veiler or something like that, Rainbow Karibo. But I know you need Max C. Like, against a deck like Infernities, you really need Max C. Because if they go first and combo on you, it's just hard to beat that deck. Alright, so Denis starts off by sending a back row. Creighton mirrors and sends one back row. And passes. You would think this wouldn't turn into a grind game, but since they're both playing hands, it's kind of like a mirror match in a little bit, just because it's a hand mirror match, but, you know, rulers over artifacts and trap tricks. I wonder if Crane can come back from that Malkat. So now Denis sets another monster. One of them has to be a Flame Veil Guard, I'm guessing. these two mostly play modern Yu-Gi-Oh. That's why they're not. They like, you guys probably recognize Denis. He's played a little bit more Edison than Creighton. But yeah, these two primarily play modern Yu-Gi-Oh. And one thing I've noticed, because obviously we switched over to HAT at my locals. We still do one Edison local a week, but like the amount of modern Yu-Gi-Oh players or people that I haven't seen play in years, like you guys who are watching my channel, who maybe watch both, you probably noticed that there's a lot of new faces for HAT. And these are people I've known for a long time. They don't want to play Edison, but they will play HAT. It's interesting. Okay. Here comes Dragon Shrine. Remember, it's a double foolish. But first you have to send a normal monster, and then you can. Now you don't have to send a normal monster, but if you want the two foolishes, you have to. One of them has to be a normal dragon. So he's gonna send Blue Eyes. How good would this card be in Dragon Turbo if it was out? Just being able to dump stone, just foolish stone and Blue Eyes first turn. Yeah, you dump Blue Eyes and White Stone, search Blue Eyes. So he sends Tidal, but he can't summon Tidal right now, can he? No, he has two Ice Hands in the graveyard, so he can't summon it. So you're seeing the synergy with the Ice Hands and the Fire Hands and the Tidal and the Blaster. Soul Charge! So we'll go over Soul Charge real quick, since it has not been activated this duel yet. I don't think. You can only activate one Soul Charge per turn. You cannot conduct your battle phase the turn you activate Soul Charge, unless if it's a activation negated. And special summon as many monsters as possible, and if you do, you take 1,000. Or you target monsters, special summon them, and if you do, you take 1,000. So since here, Crane chained Didi Crow to the Soul Charge, only Tidal got banished. Blue Eyes hit the field, so he's only going to take 1,000 damage. It doesn't fizzle with Crow like a Pot of Avarice. And there, since Tidal was banished, Denis chose to use Tidal's effect to search a Mythic Water Dragon. So he Synchro Summons... Wait, no, Denis, come on, man. This isn't modern Yu-Gi-Oh! Okay, that was funny. And here he compulses the Azurize. Normal summons Tree Dragon. Special summons the Water Dragon. So we already went over these two. Is he under Max C or something? Why didn't he keep going? Oh, he comes Sanctum. Oh, I think he's responding to Sanctum. Okay, so Sanctum popped the Tree Dragon. Oh my god. That's the first time someone's done that on camera. Put a monster in the... I forgot the name of the zone. Whatever the zone's called. I retired before Lynx came out. I did play a little bit of Lynx, like, occasionally. But, yeah, I'm not a... I'm not an expert on Lynx. Okay, so let's see. We're at 8,000. Oh, no. Denis paid 1,000 for the Soul Charge. Okay, how many cards is... Who's up on cards? I can't really see Denis's hand. I think he's got about 6 cards. What's Crane? Crane's looking at his extra deck, so maybe he's planning to make a rank 4. Or he might tribute for a Moral Attack. I saw him do that once, and here comes Karma Cut. Discard Stone, Banish Moral Attack, Search Blue Eyes. Okay. Does Crane have any more? Oh, he passed. I think Crane passed. Did he? Or no, never mind. I thought he did. Sorry, guys. It's just not much action is going on right now. Ooh, there we go. 3 back rows from Creighton. You have to do a lot more thinking in HAT format than in Edison, in my opinion. Not saying it's more skill for anything, just you just have more plays. That's just the truth. A lot of the times in Edison, because you only have, like, one normal summon per turn, like, except maybe the Frog deck and Dragon Turbo, but, like, the other decks, like, Vayu and Black Wings, which are two of the top decks, like, those, your turns are pretty straightforward in those two decks most of the time. So here comes a second Soul Charge from Denis. Let's see how many he's going to bring out. Bring them out. Bring them out. Okay, so he targets three. And let's see if Creighton has a response. Brings out Blue Eyes, Red Dragon. Sorry, Blue Eyes, Flambeau Guard, and Mythic Tree Dragon. So he pays 3,000. So it should be 8,000 to 4,000 synchros into another Azurais. Or he's thinking about it. Yep. Synchro summons Azurais. Special summon is a water dragon, so now you can make an 8. Or a level 4. So he's going to make what? Felgrand, maybe. What else would he make? Okay, it is a ghost rare Felgrand, okay. But he can't attack because he's soul charged. Let's hope there's no illegal moves. Everyone's been making illegal moves on the channel lately. I even caught myself doing it in the previous video. I made one mistake, which I hardly ever do. I think I can only recall myself ever making two illegal, like only twice I've made illegal moves. One time I remember I set a monster after I had already normal summoned. Neither me nor my opponent caught it, and then yesterday's video against Crane, I must have messed up life points somewhere. Okay, sorry guys, I messed up life points. I think I missed some damage. Yeah, I must have missed some damage earlier, but Crane went for Cowboy, and then Denis tried to negate with Felgrand, and he Divine Wrathed it. Okay, so here he goes, normal summon Curry Bandit. So Curry Bandit, the turn is normal summoned. You can excavate the top 5 cards of your deck. Add one of the excavated spell traps to your hand, and the rest go to the graveyard. See, I apologize for the life points mess up. I must have missed some attacking. This is why I always prefer the players keep track of the life points on camera, but Denis doesn't keep track of his own life points. And Crane's using a calculator, but you can't really see it on the screen. I'll be more careful this game. Okay. Crane activating his Dragon Shrine. I'm pretty sure that's what he added off of the Curry Bandit. And then Crane during his turn set 4 and summoned Karkar D. Karkar D basically cannot be special summoned. During your main phase, I don't think you can special summon either the turn you use Karkar D's effect. Yeah, I'm pretty sure you can't. So you basically normal summon it during your main phase 1, tribute it, draw 2 cards, and go straight to end phase. That's the best way I can explain it. Maybe I missed some things just because it's a long effect. So here, Denis special summons Blaster, Crane chains Maxi, and since Tidal was banished, Tidal's effect will activate to add a water dragon from his deck to his hand. He chooses Mythic Water Dragon. And here comes Deep Dark Trap Hole, which is basically bottomless for level 5 or higher monsters. Now Denis normal summons Quackumeru Drago. Attacks him for 19. Let's see if Creighton responds to the Quackumeru Drago. I guess this card's good because it stops artifacts from coming out. So he reveals Mythic Water Dragon to keep Quackumeru Drago on the field. But yeah, Fire Hand outs Quackumeru Drago. That's like the only problem. Yeah, so Crane takes 300. Fire Hand pops the Drago and then special summons Ice Hand. Attacks him for 14. Let me try not mess up life points this game. Crane sets 5 back row. Okay. But we know Denis sides into Malevolent Catastrophe. 58-66. So some of you might be wondering if Denis would have won that game had he not soul charged for three. But Creighton could have just made Heartland Draco, which is a level 4 XYZ monster that attacks you directly. It's 2,000 attack. So they just... A lot of times, decks will just get you in that range, and they just beat you with Heartland Draco. So here comes... Oh, Burial! Returns Blaster, Tidal, and Blue Eyes. Do I have life points correct? Or did I mess up again? No, I'm pretty sure he hit him for... Let me see. Yeah, he hit him with the Drago. No, I should have life points, right? It should be 58-66. So now, Denis normal summons Fire Hand after special summoning Tidal. Fire Hand attacks into the Ice Hand. Since Denis has no spell and traps, Ice Hand effect's not going to do anything. It's not going to pop anything, so it's not going to special summon a Fire Hand. Here comes compulses the Fire Hand. Now Tidal attacks the Ice Hand. Uh-oh, he just showed his other spell and trap card. So he activates Artifact Ignition, which is basically an MST, but you have to set an artifact from your deck. He MST'd his own Moral Attack, when it's destroyed in your spell and trap card zone during your opponent's turn. Goes to the grave, then you special summon itself, and then when it's special summoned during your opponent's turn, pop any face-up card your opponent controls, doesn't target. It's optional. I think in the past I said it was mandatory. No, it's not mandatory. I thought it was, but it wasn't. Alright, so here comes Dragon Shrine. After he special summons Blaster, Crane chains Cyclone to the Dragon Shrine and targets his Moral Attack and the Dragon Shrine. So now, again, same thing. Moral Attack will special summon itself. Get rid of Fire Hand. Sorry, get rid of Blaster. Did they forget? This is all in Denis's turn? Wow. Yeah, it looks like this is all in Denis's turn. So he special summons Redox by banishing Tidal and another Dragon Ruler. Just trying to stay alive. Probably doesn't want Creighton to like hit him for, what, 40, 56 basically? And get him in Heartland Draco range. So he goes for Pallades, which you need two level 5 light monsters to XYZ summon it. It's a quick effect. During either player's turn, you can attach one material to return any card on the field to the owner's hand. So you can do your own card. So here he hits him for 14, 25, 39. So it should be 58, 27. How many cards are in Crane's hand? He's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cards total. And how many are... It looks like Denis has a full hand as well. So who will... Will Denis be able to fight out of this and get his second win? Or will Crane get his first win on the channel? Start calling Denis Seto Kaiba, man. Because the one time he won in Edison was with Dragon Turbo. He loves them dragons. And he played Blue Eyes in his, obviously in his Dragon Turbo deck, and he's playing Blue Eyes here. So yeah, we're gonna have to call him Kaiba. If he wins with Blue Eyes in two different formats, we gotta call this man Seto Kaiba. All right, come on, Denis. Can you get out of this? Let's see. Denis is thinking a long time. Probably because he knows the game is on the line now, so he has to make a move. He's staring down Pallades, Ice Hand, a back row. See, it depends on how much time is left on the clock, but if my opponent takes a long time and the clock is running short, sometimes I do get upset. One thing I have noticed is a lot of people take a long time to side deck. Like, I'm almost always the first one to side. no matter against a lot of people I play against, and I'm just sitting there waiting for like two minutes, waiting for, or 3 minutes sometimes, just waiting for them to finish. Yeah, Dennis definitely took a long time here. I can't defend him. So he starts off by special summoning Blaster. Banishes Fire Hand from his hand. Or Debris Dragon and Fire Hand. Okay. Chains DD Crow, so the Blaster gets banished. Yep, that hurts. So you saw it there. Blaster got banished, so Dennis's the effect of search can't activate because he already tried to use the effect of special summon itself. So he normal summons Mythic Tree Dragon. So he chooses just to bounce the Mythic Tree Dragon. Banishes two to special summon Redox. Attacks over Ice Hand for 200. So we're at 56-27, then he activates Gold Sark. Yeah, but this is not looking good. I mean, Palladius can already run over Redox. So he banishes Tempest, has no targets left for Tempest. Activates Wing Blast, puts the Redox on top of his deck with no Dragon Rulers, then it's conceded. So congrats to Creighton, getting his first win on the channel. Second time HAT has won on the channel. Hope you guys enjoyed that finals. Let me know if I missed anything or any tips and tricks. I'm still new to HAT format. I did play it 10 years ago, but I'm still, you know, learning as I go. I'm playing in like two tournaments a week. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed it. And for those of you guys who may be wondering, I will be attending the RBET New York for Edison this weekend. So I'll be there if you guys want to come say hi.